गुड
गुड
मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग
सर।
सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग सर।
सर। ओके सो लेट मी वेलकम यू ऑल टू द फाइनल डे ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल्स फॉर दिस वीक। एंड वी हैव अराउंड टू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स शेड्यूल्ड फॉर डिस्कशन टुडे। इफ यू स्प्लिट देम इंडिविजुअली इट बिकम्स फोर, बट अदरवाइज द principle and the way you do it is quite similar. So we will be dealing with it together. Okay. So what we are going to deal with is detection of lysine decarboxylase enzyme and ornithine decarboxylase enzyme. We call it as lysine decarboxylase test or ornithine decarboxylase test. So because it's decarboxylation and of amino acids, we are going to be dealing with both of it together. And in case of the next experiment that is scheduled today, you will be learning about checking for susceptibility towards two chemical components, which is bacitracin and novobiocin, which Nitin said will deal with. So I will be dealing with the decarboxylase test part, which is a part of your biochemical test. And let me just quickly cast the screen. Okay, I can see that the screen is visible. At any given point of time, if you feel that I'm getting disconnected, I request Nikita and Nitin sir to please inform me, because we have a really unstable network today at the department. So please do let me know if at any given point of time I get disconnected. Please inform me on WhatsApp. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Great. So let us begin very quickly with the test, which is scheduled for today, which is lysine or ornithine decarboxylase test. Okay? So first, I want someone to tell me, what do you mean by the term decarboxylation? What does it exactly mean? Can anyone tell me what's the meaning of the term decarboxylation? The term itself says what it means. Anyone?
The removal of CO2.
Very good. Removal of carbon dioxide. D stands for removal, and carboxylation is basically related to carbon dioxide, right? So decarboxylation means removal of carbon dioxide. Now, obviously, when you learn pathways, when you do central metabolic pathway also, you will see that decarboxylation is a very commonly occurring process, and you will see several reactions where we carry out decarboxylation, mainly where we are dealing with removal of carbon dioxide. But in this experiment, as you can see, the name suggests, we are dealing with amino acids and their derivatives, and we are seeing what happens to it when you decarboxylate it. Okay? So firstly, the question should be, why would a bacterial species possess an ability to decarboxylate amino acids? Okay? We are studying lysine and ornithine, but let me tell you that bacteria may have the ability to decarboxylate other amino acids also, like arginine and, you know, other given amino acids for that matter. So why do they decarboxylate amino acids? That should be the first question. So many a times it is possible that the organism doesn't have a ready source of nutrition. Okay, it doesn't have a carbon source. Like it doesn't have a ready access to sugars. Okay, in these circumstances, they need to still survive and grow. And that's where some of the bacterial species, they have the ability to utilize amino acids as their carbon source. They metabolize amino acids as their sole carbon sources in order to gain energy and to survive. Okay? So we need to understand that only when you know, the other sources are depleted, which are easily utilizable sources, they will think of, you know, utilizing other available sources as carbon sources, like proteins or amino acids and stuff like that. You should always remember this, that when you talk about substrates which could be utilized as a source of energy, the first on the list is always carbohydrates. Okay, amongst the carbohydrates, you may have a different order of preference for different organisms depending on what kind of enzymes can they synthesize to metabolize those carbohydrates. Like we normally say, you know, in metabolic respiration, we always quote this term that glucose is the most preferred, you know, source of energy. That is basically because you take any organism as an example. You take plants, you take animals, you take microorganisms. All of these have the ability to metabolize glucose because all enzymes that are needed to metabolize glucose are ever ready in the system. So the moment glucose is provided, they can very easily utilize it, right? That's the reason why we say that it's more preferred, and that's one of the substrates which is most abundant also in our environment. So that has been the preferred source for any organism for gaining energy, okay? But within the carbohydrates, obviously, we know that organisms have differing abilities to utilize different carbohydrates. After carbohydrates, what would be preferable to use as a source of energy is going to be lipids, if they are available. Okay? Always remember that an organism wouldn't want to break down proteins readily because they have proteins inside their cells which they need for some kind of metabolic activity or maybe even proteins which are very crucial for their survival. So they would not be very happy about, you know, breaking down proteins as a source of energy because they know that they're going to need those proteins. So if lipids are present, they would prefer metabolizing lipids first after carbohydrates are exhausted. Once lipids are exhausted, then they would move because they don't have any other option left. There is no external source of energy. Then they would prefer to metabolize proteins. Okay? And within proteins also, you will learn this in next semester in your biochemistry paper, that whole proteins cannot be metabolized. Right? You have to first break them down to their monomers, which are amino acids. And those amino acids could be then metabolized by organisms. So only when the other sources are not available, and there is no option left behind, then the organisms are going to go towards amino acids. And there are different ways to metabolize amino acids. Decarboxylation is just one way. Remember this. Okay, it's just one method by which amino acids could be metabolized. There are multiple methods by which, you know, amino acid metabolism can be done and energy could be synthesized. Okay, so coming back to the decarboxylation test, let us see what happens during the process of decarboxylation. So I'm going to put up a general reaction. I want all of you to note that reaction also in your notebook. Okay, so when you talk about decarboxylation, let us consider that this is one of the amino acids that we are talking about. You have different ways of representing amino acids. This is one of the ways in which I'm representing the amino acids. Okay, so in those circumstances, you will see that if I'm going to get rid of carbon dioxide, if I'm going to remove this carbon dioxide, so what am I going to do? What am I going to be left with, right? So it's going to be RCH2NH2, right? That's going to be an amine. So when I remove the carboxyl group of an amino acid, I mean, I'm eliminating the COO minus group of an amino acid. What I'm left with is an amine, okay? And obviously, carbon dioxide is going to be liberated in this particular process. So you need to understand that this is what happens when you decarboxylate an amino acid. You're releasing carbon dioxide and simultaneously, you're going to form an amine. Now, please understand that the amine that we are talking about in this particular case, this is going to make the pH of the medium alkaline. Okay? So this could be one of the ways of detection to find out that whether, you know, the amino acid that you have provided to the organism, does the organism decarboxylate it? Does it produce an enzyme to decarboxylate the amino acid and convert it into amine? Because that's going to make your media alkaline. So you could use a pH indicator and you could check for change in the pH of the medium. Okay? So this is a general, you know, reaction of decarboxylation of amino acid. But if you ask me that specifically in terms of lysine and ornithine, what takes place? So let us first see in case of lysine, what's going to happen. Okay? So here we go for lysine. This is the structure of my lysine. Okay. Right? Now, I have to get rid of this COO group. This is what I have to get rid of. So, what I'm going to get as my product is going to be CH2, because this hydrogen is left, that's going to be taken up by the carbon, CH2, NH2. Okay, so this is the amine that is going to be produced, which we call as cadaverine. This is the amine that is synthesized by decarboxylation of glycine, by the enzyme glycine decarboxylase. Okay, so obviously as cadaverine is synthesized, you will see that the pH has to change to alkaline because it's an amine basically. Okay, so please note this reaction. You should know this reaction when you are talking about the principle because it's not a very tough reaction to do. So please quickly note it down, and once you have noted it, please type a yes in the chat box so that you know, I know that you are with me and I can go ahead. Amazing. Excellent. So I can see that most of you are done with it. So I quickly go to the next one, which is ornithine. So this is ornithine. This is what is ornithine, L-ornithine. So I'm going to decarboxylate this. We know that the enzyme is ornithine decarboxylase. Okay, so I am just going to write it in a slightly different way. Okay, so CH2 thrice mein se ek CH2 bahar nikala hai jo NH2 ke saath dikha hai, and CH2 twice. This CH will become CH2 because this hydrogen will go up and carbon dioxide will be removed. So this is what is the product, which is an amine that's called as putrescine. Okay, so cadaverine is from lysine and putrescine is formed from ornithine. Ornithine decarboxylase is the enzyme, removes the carbon dioxide, so this hydrogen gets shifted up, it becomes CH2NH. Okay, and CH2 3 mein se ek CH2 humne bahar nikal ke NH2 ke saath dikha. You can just write it as NH2 CH2 thrice also. Okay, nothing different. Okay, so this is the reaction. Now, what is the test about? So we have to understand how the test is done. And let me tell you, here is where we see the students getting confused always. Okay, the students are always confused about this particular test. So it's very important to know how it is done. And I don't want any one of you to go back with the confusion. I want each one of you to know the principles very clearly, and there should be no doubts in your mind. Okay, so let's take that, determination today and go back without any queries about this particular thing. Okay, so I'm going to write down first the media composition. For this test, we use molar decarboxylase base broth. Okay, I'll tell you why base broth as we discuss the composition of the medium. So first, let me tell you what the media has. Okay. So the media is going to have peptone, around 5 grams. It's going to have beef extract, again 5 grams. Bromocresol, purple, 0.1 grams. Cresol red, around 0.005 grams. Pyridoxal phosphate is around 0.005 grams. Glucose is present as 0.5 grams. Distilled water as 1 liter. Now, looking at this, there should be several questions in your mind. Okay. First and foremost is that why do we have two pH indicators? Why do we have bromocresol purple? Why do we have cresol red? What's the role of pyridoxal phosphate, and why the hell are we providing glucose? Okay, these should be some of the questions that we need to ask why we are doing this particular test. So glucose, there are two reasons. First, you need to have good growth for the organisms to start utilizing lysine. So to initiate growth, you provide them glucose, and you can see in 1 liter, you're providing 0.5 grams. It's like nothing. So it's just to initiate the basic growth. And let me tell you that lysine decarboxylase enzyme, it's an inducible enzyme. Okay, and its production is induced in presence of lysine in an acidic environment. So automatically, when organisms, they ferment glucose, they produce acids in the medium. So the media pH turns to acidic. Okay, now this provides a good environment for the organism to start secreting lysine decarboxylase enzyme, because they are good in number, they have acidic environment, and we will be also providing them lysine in the medium. Now your question would be, sir, we don't see lysine anywhere in the medium. So that's why we call it a base prompt, because it's the basic medium in which you can add whichever amino acid you want to test the decarboxylase for. So you can add ornithine, you can add lysine, you can add arginine. It's up to you, depending on which test you want to perform. Okay? So the media is going to, be the basal media is going to be the same. What is going to change? The amino acid that you add to the media. That's why we call this as the base media. Okay? So once glucose is exhausted, the media has turned acidic due to the acids produced from glucose. It's the best environment for these organisms to start secreting for the decarboxylase enzyme, depending on the amino acid that you have added. Pyridoxal phosphate is one of the very important cofactors that the enzyme needs to function. So that's the reason why you're supplementing pyridoxal phosphate in the medium, so that the enzyme can effectively function. Because you know that enzymes, until and unless they get their cofactors and coenzymes, they do a lot of hard work. So you have to provide it. Now we come to the question, why do we have two pH indicators? So we have bromopriazole purple, which works up to, you know, from the acidic range to a range of 6.8, that's up to 7, not beyond that. Okay, so if you talk about bromopriazole purple, in its highly acidic range, it turns to be yellow in color, and in its alkaline range, that is around 6.8 or 7, we can't even say alkaline, but near neutral range, it is going to be, you know, around purplish in color. Okay, but if you talk about crisol red, let me tell you that it works in the range of around 6 to 9. And let me tell you that in the alkaline range, it has the tendency to produce purple color. Okay, so now let us discuss, why do we have these two? So when you first inoculate the organism in the medium, no doubt it will start utilizing glucose, it will produce acid, right? So when it produces acid, the media pH is going to go towards the acidic range. So the color that will be generated is going to be yellow, because obviously when acid is generated, the pH is going to go near 5 and even below that, depending on how much of acid is produced, right? So bromocrisol purple will be active during that time, detecting the acidic pH range and generating yellow color, right? But when glucose is exhausted and the amino acid is being decarboxylated, whether it's lysine, whether it's ornithine, okay, when it's being decarboxylated, amine is being generated. So when amine is being generated and the pH is going towards alkaline range beyond 7, where bromocrisol purple can't work, what will work there? Crisol red will work there. Okay, so when it goes to that alkaline range, okay, around 7 or 8, not even 7, beyond 8 rather. So that time, the purple color generated is from crisol. Have you understood why you have two pH indicators? That's because of their pH ranges that have been involved. Are you understanding this, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, fine. Now let us talk about, how do we do this media, and how do we do this test, and how do we identify or interpret our results? Okay, so first of all, this test is carried under anaerobic conditions, because we want glucose to be fermented we need to provide it anaerobic conditions, for which we overlay our broth with sterile paraffin oil or sterile mineral oil, okay, after the inoculation is done, obviously. Okay, so first you will be given two things, okay, that is sterile molars, decarboxylase based broth, okay, that you will be given one tube having around 3 ml of it, 2.5 to 3 ml of it. Okay, and another tube will be sterile molars, decarboxylase broth with 1% L-lysine dihydrochloride. Okay, it's the salt of amino acid that's added because it needs to be soluble. So 1% L-lysine dihydrochloride. And if you are doing this for ornithine, then sterile molars decarboxylase broth with 1% of L-ornithine dihydrochloride. Okay, depending on whatever you are doing the test for. So you are using one base broth tube and another tube containing the amino acid. You're going to inoculate the test organism in both the tubes. You're going to inoculate it in the base broth, which doesn't even have the amino acid. And you are going to inoculate it in the broth, which also contains the amino acid. After you do this, you are going to, you know, overlay it with around 1 to 1.5 ml of your sterile paraffin oil or mineral oil. Okay, in both the tubes to, you know, make it an anaerobic condition. Is that very clear? So whenever we make this media in the broth, whenever we make the base broth in the lab, mama is going to divide it into two flasks. One flask will be prepared, you know, so that we can provide the base broth in the tubes to you. And the another flask is wherein it will be, you know, to this base broth, the amino acid will be added and, you know, that will be kept as the broth with the amino acid. Okay, so it will be made in bulk, the base will be made in bulk first and then it's divided into two parts. One for the base broth and another for the broth with the amino acid. Is that very clear? Normally, it's preferable that you don't add the amino acid in autoclave. So amino acid solutions should be filtered sterilized. That's the ideal way of doing it because amino acids normally should not be autoclave. Okay, so you should filter sterilize the solution and add it to the broth. But here, because we have found that it doesn't cause any harm to lysine specifically, we put it in an autoclave, which is a wrong practice. But and you should remember that it should not be done. Okay, you should filter sterilize it separately and add it to the base broth. Okay, so going back, I have inoculated my organism in the base broth as well as the broth containing the lysine. I have overlaid it with the sterile paraffin oil or mineral oil, and I am going to incubate these tubes for 24 hours. Now, please understand, I want you to tell me what would happen with the base broth containing the organism, which just does not have amino acid. Can you tell me what would be the color of that base broth after 24 hours? Initially, both the tubes are purple because bromocresol purple at pH 7 is giving us purple color itself. So when I've inoculated it, both the tubes are purple. But after incubation, after growth of the organism, can you tell me what will you see in the base broth?
Sir, yellow color.
Sir, yellow color.
Yes, yellow color, right? Because it does not have amino acid. So what is the organism going to utilize there?
Glucose,
barabar. It will utilize glucose and it is going to produce acid. So the pH of the medium will turn acidic and the color will become yellow. Is that very clear? Now let's come to the second tube, the one which contains lysine. What would be happening inside that tube? What will the organism do first?
Convert glucose.
It will consume glucose. Very good. It's going to ferment glucose. It's going to produce acid. The color of the medium will turn yellow. But after the glucose is exhausted, what is it going to do? If it has the ability to decarboxylate lysine, what will it do? Yes, Nikita?
It will secrete lysine decarboxylase.
Very good, because now the medium is acidic, and for lysine decarboxylase induction, acidic media is needed. Okay, so it will secrete lysine decarboxylase. It will decarboxylate to form what? Lysine decarboxylate होगा तो क्या बनता है?
Cadaverine.
What is that chemically? What is cadaverine chemically?
Amine.
It's an amine. So what would happen to the pH of the medium?
Alkaline.
Alkaline pH.
Very good. So now the color which turned yellow due to acid production, what will it go back to?
Purple.
So if I have a lysine decarboxylase positive organism, the next day after 24 hours, what will I see? I will see that the base broth color is? The base broth color is?
So yellow.
That is the one without lysine is yellow.
Yellow.
And the one with lysine is?
Purple.
But remember that the one with lysine has got the transformation of purple to yellow to purple. Originally it was purple. Because of acid production it became yellow and then it came back to purple. Samajh mein aa raha hai sabko?
Yes, sir.
You know, to best understand this, what I'm going to do? Guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to record a time lapse. Okay? So I'm going to incubate the tube with a camera on in front of it, and we will see how the color change takes place. So when I record it for you, for the demonstration part, I have decided to do a time lapse. Wouldn't it be fun to see the color changing from purple to yellow and then back to purple? It's going to be amazing. So let's do a time lapse and see how the process looks like. Theek hai?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Now, if the organism doesn't have the ability to decarboxylate lysine, okay, if it doesn't have the ability to break down lysine to an amine, then the base broth is anyway yellow, right? Barabar, the base broth will be yellow because wahan to glucose bhi hai, so wo to yellow hi hoga. Can you tell me what will be the status of the molar decarboxylase broth with lysine if the organism doesn't have the ability to decarboxylate lysine?
It will remain yellow.
Very good. So both the tubes will remain yellow because the organism will utilize the glucose present in it. Right? And it will turn to yellow, but it will not go back to purple. Is that very clear?
Yes, sir.
अगर मुझे दोनों ट्यूब्स येलो दिखे तो इसका मतलब है कि वो उस पर्टिकुलर अमाइनो एसिड को डीकार्बोक्सिलेट नहीं कर सकता. अगर मुझे बेस ब्रॉथ येलो दिखा और अमाइनो एसिड वाला ट्यूब पर्पल दिखा या रेडिश भी दिखा, तो इट्स एन इंडिकेशन दैट इट हैज डीकार्बोक्सिलेटेड अमाइनो. ओके, सेम गोज फॉर ऑर्निथिन ऑल्सो. द ओनली डिफरेंस इज दैट इन द मोलर डीकार्बोक्सिलेज ब्रॉथ इंस्टेड ऑफ लाइसिन यू हैव ऑर्निथिन. यस, the performing part, the interpretation part remains the same. Okay? So I will quickly show you the image.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, in the standard bacteria, standard cultures that we use for testing this, what would be the average time that it requires to change into yellow and then again into purple?
See, that depends on organism to organism and which media you are transferring this organism from. Remember that. Okay? Because the media that it comes from is going to be a deciding factor of how fast or slow the organism is going to grow. If it is a fresh culture, it will grow faster. You will see that glucose utilization takes place quicker, and maybe in, you know, around 6 to 7 hours, you should be able to see the color change towards yellow. And then the rest of the time, it will obviously take some time, because if there's going to be a lag, it has to first induce the production of lysine decarboxylase, and then the decarboxylase enzyme will act. So it's going to be yellow for a good amount of time. Only, you know, after around 18 hours to 24 hours, you will be able to see that it has started turning purple. So many organisms, they, you know, are very slow in doing this. quite slow in doing this. So even you may see very faint color changes taking place as well. Okay, so it depends from one organism to the other, and it depends on which media it's going to be coming from. Let me know if the slide is visible. You will have to switch to my another presentation, which is the...
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So I will show you the images. So you can see over here in this particular slide, this is the base broth, which has been labeled as the base, this first one. Okay, you can see all tubes have been labeled with paraffin oil. You can see that, right? So you can see that this is the base tube. The very first one on the left is the base tube, which has turned yellow after incubation. Okay, and the rest have been the test. Okay, and let us say all these are for lysine. So these are three different organisms. We will call them as A, B, and C. Okay, so you can see that A tube has gone back to the purple color. So it's a positive test, which means that it has gone from purple to, you know, yellow to purple. The B one, you can see it is remaining yellow, which means that the organism growing in here doesn't have the ability to produce decarboxylate enzymes. So it's not able to decarboxylate the amino acid. So it just remains yellow. It doesn't go back to purple color. And you can see in the third case, the color is not very strong, but it is towards purple, which means that this organism is also positive for decarboxylation. Okay, because it has gone from purple to yellow to purple. You know, your base in a way is also going to act as a control, okay, to show that indeed the organism is able to grow in the media, it's able to ferment glucose. It's also acting as a control over here for you, to see that the sugar has been fermented and the acids have been produced. Because, you know, if you're going to see the tube directly after 24 hours, it's very difficult actually to comment whether, you know, it has gone from purple to yellow to purple. Because when I inoculated it was purple, when I'm seeing it is purple. So I don't know if the change occurred or not. So this control-based tube tells me that indeed the change would have occurred, because here in this, where there is no amino acid, I can see yellow. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say, students? Does it make sense?
Yes,
to you?
Yes, sir.
So, can anyone repeat the principle, please? Can someone tell me what are we doing in this test? Part mein bolo chalega. Pehle mujhe batao ki molar base broth or with 1% lysine mein kya difference, aur wo hum do alag tubes kyun maintain kar rahe? Kaun batayega mujhe? See, I don't want to name you guys, okay? So it's preferable that aap mein se koi khud voluntarily bolo. Galat hua to theek hai, kya problem hai? At least correct ho jayega jo bhi hum galat bol rahe.
Sir, we used to, first of all, we have to check the organisms if they are capable of decarboxylation of amino acids. So we use two media, that is the base broth and with lysine. So if we use then after incubate, we have to incubate organisms in both the broth. So after incubation, if we will compare the results in case of the base broth, that we have added no amino acids, so the organisms will utilize the glucose which is present, and afterwards they don't have anything, so the medium chromocresol will change the color and medium will appear yellow. Whereas in other tube in which we have added lysine, if the organisms are capable of decarboxylation, so after the utilization of glucose, they will again utilize the lysine. And after this, due to the amine production, the broth color will change back to purple again. And if the organism are not capable of producing, then it will remain yellow.
Okay, great. Why do you overlay paraffin? Anyone else can tell me this? Why do you want to overlay it with paraffin?
To maintain another condition.
Okay. Can someone tell me why have we provided glucose in the medium?
To initiate growth.
And? To initiate growth.
To get acidic condition.
To create an acidic condition.
Yeah. Why do we for want the, an acidic condition? Yes, sir.
For the enzyme to work. The decarboxylase enzyme, because it works only in acidic medium.
For the enzyme to just work, or even to induce the production of the enzyme?
Yeah, sir, to induce.
Okay, Very good. Can someone tell me why do we have pyridoxal phosphate in the media?
It is a cofactor for the enzyme to grow quick, to be produced quickly.
Is cofactor needed for production of the enzyme? Or is it for the enzyme to function? Yes, Anjana?
Sir, to function, sorry.
No issues. Chalega. Can someone tell me why do we have two pH indicators in the media? Why do we have bromocrystal purple as well as crystal red? Someone can give a try at least. Ishan, can you give a try?
Yes, sir. It is due to the pH ranges. Bromocrystal is from
till which range? Utna bolo. Is it till neutral or does it go beyond neutral?
No, it goes beyond neutral.
Goes beyond neutral?
No, sir, it remains still neutral.
Okay, so what's the role of bromocrystal purple to indicate?
The acidic condition.
The acidic condition.
Right, so it shows you yellow color in acidic conditions, and at around pH 7, it's going to show you purple color. Okay, and what about crystal red? Crystal red functions in the?
When the amine is produced
in alkaline range.
In the alkaline range. So it helps to turn the media to purple, right? To indicate that a lot of amines have been produced. Okay. Fine. So I hope that the test principle is clear. Ishan, I hope it's making sense to you now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Fine. Any more questions that you guys have about the decarboxylase test?
Sir.
Yes.
In this picture you are presenting of the test results, the second tube is quite brighter, like it can be easily identified as purple, but the
you are talking about the difference in color in the second and the fourth tube,
yes,
right?
Yes, second and fourth tube.
So that is what I was mentioning, that it depends on how strong the ability is of decarboxylation. See, you need to understand that many a times what happens is that the organisms are slow decarboxylators as well. They may not, that's what we say as a weak test or a, you know, faintly positive test, because the organism is gradually decarboxylating. It's not quick enough as the other bacterial species would be. So the amine accumulation is gradual. So many a times the color may not be as dark as you see in case of the second tube. But that surely doesn't mean that they are not positive. They are positive, but they are slow decarboxylators. Is that clear for this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is.
Anything else? Yes. Yes, sir.
Sir, could you repeat the part of why do we need sterile molasse decarboxylase base broth and plus a different tube for base broth plus lysine?
Yes. So see, if I use just the broth containing the amino acid, let's say that I don't use the base at all. Okay. I have just one tube, which is the broth plus lysine. Okay, I inoculate the organism and I'm going to incubate the tube. Okay, and when I'm inoculating it, it's purple in color. Okay, and when I remove it after 24 hours, it's purple in color. Okay, now I need to understand whether the test worked here or not. I just don't see any color changes, remaining as it is, purple. So I need to know whether the organism has grown over here or not. Many a times the growth may not be clearly visible. Some organisms are shameless. They show you turbidity in the broth, you know, dense turbidity, which tells you how baba grow hua hai. Kai case mein turbidity kam hoga. So aise cases mein, mujhe samajh mein kaise aayega ki really kuch reaction hua bhi ya nahi hua. Kyunki wo purple tha, purple hi hai. So agar maine iske saath ek base broth rakha, jisme amino acid hai hi nahi, तो उसमें ऑर्गेनिज्म सिर्फ ग्लूकोज यूज करके कम से कम येलो कलर प्रोड्यूस करेगा. सो दैट ट्यूब इज गोइंग टू रिमेन येलो एंड द वन विद अमीनो एसिड विल टर्न येलो एंड देन टर्न टू पर्पल. सो आई कम टू नो दैट यस द ऑर्गेनिज्म इज ग्रोइंग इन दिस मीडियम. आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस अप टिल नाउ?
यस सर. यस सर. थैंक यू.
डज दिस मेक सेंस टू ऑल ऑफ यू? आई होप एवरीवन हैज अंडरस्टूड ऑल दीस पॉइंट्स.
Sir,
in this picture we can see that second and fourth are different in color. So in fourth, we the time is a factor of concentration of the enzyme.
See, that is what I said. When I say slow decarboxylation, it means that the time required for decarboxylation could be more, or the production rate of the enzyme is itself slow. It could be either of it. And if that has to be analyzed, you have to perform a different kind of a test wherein you increase the time of incubation, or you isolate these organisms and see how much lysine decarboxylase do they produce by lysing the cells open, extracting the enzyme, purifying it, and finding out the activity. So that's going to be a completely different set of work that you would be doing to understand the metabolic fashion of this particular organism. So it could be either because of slow process of converting lysine, or it could also be because the decarboxylase enzyme is being produced in lower concentration, right? Because expression differs from one organism to the other.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, sounds great. So I think if there are no more questions related to this, we are done with this particular test, and maybe Nitin sir can take over from this particular point. Nitin sir, if there is anything that I have missed, sir, please do add.
Okay, sir. I'm just giving one question over here that can be one of the probability they might face during performing the practical. So obviously it is simple one, but obviously whatever you have just discussed in the last part of that practical, I think that is going to matter over there. Okay.
Yes.
So yes, students, you can tell me that what could be your interpretation if you found the both the tubes having purple color after sufficient incubation. Obviously you have inoculated, but at the end of the sufficient incubation at a specific temperature, you are getting observation something like both tubes, that is the mollus broth containing lysine and without lysine, both are having the purple color. So what will you do and what is your interpretation? Yes, sir. Is my question making any sense?
Yes, so,
yes, the question is correct. And they have to think of what has gone wrong.
Yes, yes. Someone is answering. Please go ahead. Sorry, but I think voice was so much.
No, I heard it clearly. I think the student said that the base broth also contains amino acids, right? Who was it? Nirmiti?
Yes.
Yeah.
But I mentioned about it that one is strictly not containing the lysine, another one is strictly containing the lysine. Okay. Media is well, मतलब composition के हिसाब से correct है. हम ऐसा नहीं करेंगे आपको गलती से दोनों में.
Sir, it can be two things according to me. Like one can be either we have not inoculated it, maybe not properly. It is not possible. If we have inoculated, we'll be knowing. Second is maybe it's not utilizing only glucose, the organism which is present. It can be one possibility.
Okay.
But so that is not, that is very rare case.
Yes, anyone at the time, please.
Sir, could you please repeat the question?
Okay, so my question was something like this. What is your interpretation if you observe for this particular test, okay? LDC, that is lysine decarboxylase. If you observe that at the end of the incubation, at a sufficient time for a sufficient time at a sufficient time temperature, if you found that both the tubes, the tube containing lysine and the tube not containing the lysine, both are having the purple color, okay, and both were well inoculated under the supervision. So both were inoculated, but at the end of the incubation, you are getting observation something like this, that both tubes are showing the purple color. Okay.
So maybe while inoculating the person, like by mistake, they killed the inoculum itself, or it could be because of the peptone, because usme bhi amino acids hai na, so like that could be one.
So yes. So how will you come to know whether that organism has been grown in that or it is not growing at all?
the turbidity, we can check for the turbidity.
Okay, yes. So obviously some extent of turbidity can be also observed if the organism is not growing somewhere over there. Okay. And if you found that there is no turbidity at all, and that's why we can say that the organism has not grown in that particular tubes at all, and that's why both media or both the tubes are showing the purple color, that is something like a sterile ones. Okay. Obviously positive ke liye aapne abhi interpretation dekha ki without lysine wala aapko yellow dikhna chahiye, aur with lysine wala agar wo lysine dikhavoge is positive to aapko purple dikhna chahiye. तो ग्रोथ ही नहीं अगर वहां पे हुआ रहेगा तो वी कैन नॉट इंटरप्रेट, वी कैन सिंपली ऑब्जर्व फॉर द टर्बिडिटी वेदर इट इज देयर और नॉट. ओके, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू कैन गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ अ कंक्लूजन और इंटरप्रिटेशन. ओके,
यस सर.
आई थिंक दैट इन दिस सर्कमस्टेंसेस व्हेन यू आर आस्क्ड सच क्वेश्चंस स्पेशली इन वाइवा यू विल हैव टू मेंशन ऑल पॉसिबल पॉसिबिलिटीज. ओके,
हां, यस सर, यस.
सो यू विल हैव टू यू कांट स्टिक टू वन रीजन बिकॉज़ देयर आर मल्टीपल थिंग्स दैट कैन हैपन इन दिस सिनेरियो. Right, so you will have to analyze that and accordingly answer, because there are a lot of variants which can happen in this particular case. Okay, as far as glucose not being utilized is concerned, that's very difficult. Okay, so either you can comment on the viability of the cells and you can say that okay, you did the inoculation but the cells may not be viable if you can't see turbidity. But if you see turbidity, then it's an indication that it's utilizing some other nitrogenous components in the media and turning the media alkaline. Okay, so you will have to give scenarios and answer the question. Okay, like saying first that you are not able to see turbidity at all and the tubes are very clear, then it could be possible that the cells are not viable, so the cell viability should be tested. Then the second scenario, if there is turbidity and then still you see that both tubes are purple, then in that case maybe peptone which is being utilized. So place the points clearly and then elaborate on it. That always works in your favor, and you yourself will also not get confused.
Yes, sir.